Combine do know how to upgrade a gun. I'll give them that.
Uh-oh. This guy's not wearing a shirt. Two shells left. Thank you.
Last shell.
I'm out.
Particle effects present an interesting challenge in VR due to stereopsis, which is our ability to discern the depth of objects from two slightly different views of the world we see from our two eyes. Traditional particle systems, as seen on the left, were typically implemented as a series of flipbook images displayed on relatively large polygons, which orient to face the player. Each series of images would contain effectively a little movie of a more complex phenomenon, like a wafting puff of smoke or a flickering flame, and so on. For the monoscopic rendering used in non-VR systems, this approach holds up well and is widely used across the industry. Because of the stereo rendering used in VR, however, players can easily see the flat cards, resulting in the unconvincing effect seen on the left. To address this, we had to update our particle rendering techniques for VR. The particle system on the right is an updated VR-friendly version of the older effect seen on the left. One technique we used on large cards
One of the tenets of Half-Life game design is creating crafted, moment-to-moment experiences that players participate in as they progress through the game. Sometimes this means playing with emotional responses to turn something undesirable into a memorable highlight. This collapsed section of the hotel features this type of experience. Players are often instinctively pulled to the safest-looking location in a given area, and here, that would be the well-lit corridor above. But when they get there, they find their way blocked by a Combine power shield. The power cable to shut down the Combine force field leads them back down into the poison headcrab-infested darkness below, a place they really didn't want to go. These larger gameplay spaces also need to be resilient to player choice. So even if a player chooses not to head up to the well-lit corridor, they likely will still have the same trepidation about heading down into the darkness below. After the player has braved the darkness and sheltered themselves in the lit room where they're safe from the wandering headcrabs, they're faced with the daunting task of cutting the power to the Combine force field, because this has the side effect of plunging the area into darkness. Not only does that make the situation worse, since the player must make their way out of the pitch blackness with only a flashlight, but the path to the exit is back through all the poison headcrabs. We spent a lot of time tuning this experience through careful playtesting and evaluation, and often, when recounting their travels through the hotel in post-playtest discussions, players would recall this moment of being plunged into darkness as a high point, managing to combine a feeling of amusement with the overall sense of dread.
That Combine weapon's unbonded.
How are you sure?
It's still in the case. They never leave them in the case.
Nice.
I didn't even need to edit your genetic code.
No, you'd love that.
That's okay. There'll be a next time.
Oh, man. Three mags left. Thank you.
common game design problem is that of resource placement, and this spot in the game is a good example. Players have just left an area where they acquired the Combine submachine gun, and whenever they get a new weapon, it's a new area, which features one of the hardest combat arenas in the game, where they must fight two revivers at the same time. How much ammunition can we expect the player to have?
Come on!
3 south line. One left.
Did that dog come back again, Alyx?
Yeah, this one was kind of rough.
You're all right, though, right?
Yeah, Russ. I'm good.
Well, we've got to get you out of here and up to the roof.
I'm working on it.